Okay, so magandang hapon ulit. So our topic for this evening, the first topic is Python statement, indentation and comment. So we already discussed this topic last meeting. So we're going to review. Okay, so sabi natin yung Python statement ay anything or instructions. So these are instructions that the Python interpreter can execute. So, tawag natin doon ay statement. So, we have A is equal to 1. So, this is another statement. So, assignment statement. Aside from assignment, if, for, while, and other statements. Ano? So, this is an example of multi-line statement. So, we are assigning this value into the variable A. So, dito, nakaka-create tayo ng isang statement, pero meron siyang multiple lines. So, para magawa natin yun, so we can use the continuation character, which is backslash. Okay. So, aside from using backslash, we can also use parentheses, brackets, and braces. So, dito sa example natin, we use brackets para dun sa continuation instead of using backslash character for multi-line statement. Isang statement lang siya, pero yung statement natin ay binubuo ng multiple lines. Okay. So, another example is the use of braces. Okay. So, we have the square brackets pala. Rather, so we have the square brackets. So, we can also use this ano, for multi-line statement. And then, another thing is we're going to have multiple statements in a single line. So, we can use semicolon. So, in this example, so we have 1, 2, 3. 3 statements and close the statement with a semicolon. So, isang statement, tatlong statement sa isang line. So, ito yung ginagawa natin. Okay, next. So, yung indention is it's also very important part sa pagko-code natin sa Python kasi ginagamit natin ito to define block of code. Okay, so sa Python comment, so we can use hashtag. So this is a single line comment. So this is an example of putting a comment in our program, in our cell, dun sa ginagamit natin na Jupyter Notebook or Google Colab. Okay? Aside from comment, no, so meron din tayong multi-line comment. So, aside from using the hash symbol or hashtag symbol, we can use a triple quotation or triple double quotation, you know, for multi-line comment. So, this is an example of declaring multi-line comment. So, isa, dalawa, tatlo, tatlong lines ng comment. Ano? So, alam naman natin, ang comments are non-executable statements. Ano? So, hindi sila statements. So, ginagamit natin ito para mas mabasa, para mas maging readable yung ating code. Okay, so another topic that we already discussed is about Python variables. And then, we will continue it ano, tungkol sa constant and literals. So, sabi natin, ang variables ay named location used to store data in the computer memory. Okay. So it in this example, so we have number is equal to 10. So this is a very simple declaration we also assign ano, assigning and declaring variable value ano with the corresponding literal value. So ang napansin natin dito no sa Python, so we do not explicitly declare yung data type kung anong klase yung ating ina-assign. So, ang reason dyan, so in this example, no, so we have number is equal to 10, and then number is equal to 1.1. So, from integer and then naging float. No? So, yun yung characteristic kasi ng variable. So, the value of the variable can change, can vary. So, today, for example, for this instance, the value is integer, and then later on, so pwedeng naging value niya is float. Ano? So, sabi nga natin, as analogy, so we can think of variables as bag, in which we can store books ano in that particular bag, and we can change ano, or we can replace the value of the bag ano anytime. So pwedeng iba-iba yung maging value ng bag. So yun yung characteristic ng variables. So ito yung reason why variables in Python, so we do not explicitly declare or assign the data type, because we do not actually assign values to the variables itself. Instead, yung Python ay gumagamit ng object, ano? So yung object ang nag-hold ng value, ano? Yun yung nagiging value ng variables. So reference kasi siya, ano? So yung reference na yan, so yun yung ina-assign natin dun sa variable. So aside from identifying or knowing how to declare variables in Python, so we could also learn how to use the assignment operator to assign. So equal sign is the assignment operator. So in this example, so these are string, so apple.com, so this is a string na ina-assign natin dun sa website, and then the output here would be apple.com. Ayan. So we use the Python, the assignment operator. Okay, so sabi natin Python is a type inferred language. So sabi natin we do not explicitly define the variable type or the data type. So it automatically knows, ano? It automatically knows that the apple.com is a string and declares the website variables as string. So kung number naman yung ilalagay niyan, kasi since reference nga siya, hindi naman nga sa object siya inilalagay. At yung object na yun, siya na yung bahalang nag-identify whether this kind of variable or data is string, or it is a numerical or a boolean value. Yan. So ganun yun. Okay, so let's have this example. So aside from declaring variables, we could also have assigning multiple values to multiple variables. So in this example, so we declare A, B, C. So meron tayong tatlong variable. So tatlong variable ay nag-a-assign tayo ng tatlong value. So we use equal sign. So the value 5 will be assigned to A, 3.2 is B, 3 and then hello will be assigned to variable C. So this is how we assign values or multiple values to multiple variables. So dito naman sa pangalawang example, so we can assign a same value, ano, to multiple variables. Ibig sabihin yung x, y, z ang magiging value niyan ay same. So string na same. So ipiprint yan, so the output here will be same, same, same. Dito naman na magiging output will be 5, 3.2, and then hello. And then aside from learning about variables, another important thing na kailangan natin maintindihan is tungkol sa constant. So pag sinabi natin constant is a type of variable whose value cannot be changed. So it is very helpful to think that constants as containers that hold information which cannot be altered or which cannot be changed, ano? So yun yung characteristic naman ng constant, kaya constant. So yung ang opposite naman niya, yung variable, ano, yung variable, ang value naman ng variable ay napapalitan. So sa constant, once na-declare natin yung value na to, so yun na yung magiging fixed value niya. So this is an example of how to declare variable. So patulad lang din ng pagde-declare ng variable, kaya lang pagkakaiba nila, so para malaman natin na ito ay constant, so we use capital letters, pi for pi, and then the assigned value, gravity 9.8. Ayan. Okay. So, another important thing na kailangan natin intindihan is yung tinatawag na rules and naming convention for variables and constant. So, meron tayong mga rules and naming convention. So, para mas madali natin maintindihan yung ating mga codes or yung ating mga identifiers. So, constant and variable or variable names, ito yung mga identifiers, should have a combination of letters. So it can be lowercase letters or uppercase letters, yung A to Z. So those are letters. Or it can also contain digits, 0 to 9. Pwede din na magkaroon ng underscore. So these are the examples of variables. This is a variable for variable, this is constant kasi all capital letter. So ito naman yung tinatawag na camel case, ano? So nagka-camel case. So alam nyo naman na yung camel case, ano? So ginagamit natin ito. Bakit ba gumagamit ng camel case? Kailan ba ginagamit ang camel case? Meron ba sa inyo na gustong sumagot? Okay, so ginagamit natin yung camel case kapag meron tayong variable na gustong gamitin, yung variable name ay composed of two or more words. So ginagawa natin yung pagka-camel case kasi bawal ang paglalagay ng space. Okay, so sige. Another thing, ano, so kailangan din natin maintindihan na pag tayo nagbibigay ng pangalan, make sure that yung binibigay natin na name ay may sense. So for example, instead of using V, ano, V, or for example, XYZ, so we can use the word for this letter, ano? So we can although we can understand V, but it is more meaningful when we use the word vowel. Or for example, score, instead of sabihin natin na A or score 1, so we can have score instead of using a single character as variable. So it makes a lot of sense, ano, instead of using a single character as variable name. Another thing, so if we want to create variable having two words, ito yung sinasabi natin kanina na nagka-camel case tayo. So if we don't want to use camel casing, so we can place underscore, ano, i-replace natin dun sa space is yung underscore to separate them. For example, yung my and name, so you want to use these two words as single variable, so we place underscore in between these two words. Okay, so yung camel case, ang ginagawa, pinagdidikit natin yung dalawang words and we make sure that the first character or the first letter of the succeeding word, capital. Okay, and then number 4, so sa pag-declare naman daw or pag-create ng constant, so it is possible to use all caps or capital letter for constant. So this is an example, mass, speed of light, temp, so we have pi, we have gravity, so like what we have shown you a while ago. And then sabi, we cannot use or never use special symbol. Nabanggit natin kanina yung rule number 1. So yung ating variable or constant can contain letters, numbers, and underscore. So any character except those nabanggit natin would be illegal, ano? Illegal or magkakaroon, mag-i-issue ng error. So ano yung mga symbols na hindi dapat makikita dun sa ating variable? Exclamation point, at sign, hashtag, dollar sign, percent symbol, and other special character. Another thing, sabi natin pwedeng magkaroon ng digit, pero hindi lang pwedeng sa simula. So don't start the variable name with a digit kasi pag nagsimula siya sa digit, magkakaroon siya ng error. So actually, parang same naman din ito sa C++ and sa Java na programming. So you already knew about this. So we need to reiterate ito, no, yung mga ganitong klase so that you will follow, ano, kapag kayo ay nagko-code na. Okay. So then aside from the naming convention, so tapos na tayo sa variable. So we already completed the constant. So ngayon let's talk about literals. So when we say literal, so this is a raw data given in a variable or constant. So ibig sabihin yung raw data, ito yung value, ano? Ito yung value na ina-assign natin doon sa ating variable. So merong iba't ibang klase ng literals. So unang example natin ng literals ay yung tinatawag na numeric literals. So numeric literals are immutable. So ibig sabihin unchangeable, hindi siya pwedeng mapalitan. So numeric literals can be either of the three. It can be numerical, it can be a integer, float, and complex. So yun yung tatlong numerical types: integer, float, and complex. Okay, so this is an example of how to use numeric literals in Python. So we have declared A, B, C. So for the variable A, we declare or we assign literal value So ang literal value natin dito is binary. So this one is decimal, this one is octal, this one is hexadecimal. So these are under numerical data types. Okay, so we have integer. No? So we have float. So we have integer, literal. So we have float, literals. No? So we have decimal. We have whole number, number with decimal places. Okay, so this would be the first example and then second example. And then the last literal is the complex literal. So we have 3.2. So this is the whole. So this is a number, ano? So floating value. So 3.14. And then we have J. Ano? So yung J na to, so it can also have a value. So kaya nga siya complex because of this. Ano? Yeah. So we have complex, float, and integer literals. Okay. Aside from the numeric literals, we can have string literals. String literals is a sequence of characters surrounded by quotes. It can be a single quote or double quote. It can also have triple quotes. Ano? So, ginagamit kasi natin din yung triple quotes for string. Okay, so, para naman sa character, so aside from string literals, meron din tayong character na literal. So, it is, pag sinabing character, it is a single letter or a single character surrounded by single quote or double quote. So this is an example of how to use string in string literals in Python. So the first example, ang variable name is strings, and then the value is, this is Python. So para naman sa character, so the value of car is C, ano? Character C. So for multi-line string, so we use triple quotation, ano? So meron pa tong karugtong, ano? Kaya lang ay ibig sabihin na may karugtong yan, ano? So ibig sabihin it can have multiple lines. So ginagamit natin yung triple quotation for multi-line comment and for multi-line string. Okay, so we have Unicode and row string. Ayan. So this is an example of how to use literal in Python. String literals, no? How about Boolean literals? So Boolean literals can have a value, Boolean value. O yung literals natin na Boolean can be either true or false. So in this example, so we assign x, ano, the value of x is 1 is equal to true, and then y is equal to false. So therefore, the value of x here would be true. Ano? So kapag ina-assign natin siya, ano, is true. Okay? And then we have, okay. So dito naman, gusto lang ipaliwanag dito sa example natin ay ang ating Boolean na literals ay may corresponding numerical values. Okay, so tingnan natin itong example. True, ang equivalent value niyan is 1 and false is 0. So kung true ay 1, 1 plus 4, so that is 5. So the value of A, 5, A is 5. What is the value of B? So B is false plus 10. So false is equivalent na to is 0, 0 plus 10, so that is 10. Yeah. So we have Boolean literal. Okay, so aside from Boolean literal, so meron din tayong tinatawag na collections. No? So pag sinabi natin collections, so hindi lang isa, hindi lang dalawa, or it can contains multiple values. Okay, so there are four different literal collections na pwede nating gamitin pag tayo nagpo-program sa Python. So ano-ano ito? So we have literal, list literals, we have the tuple literals, dictionary literals, and set literals. Okay, so how to declare? Ito, makinig mabuti kasi you will also work with your laboratory. And sa laboratory ninyo ay merong ganitong instruction. So kaya gusto kong bigyan ng emphasis. So to declare a list, no? So for a collection, ano? A literal collection. So to declare list, so we could use this example, ano? So the variable is fruits, and then we have list of fruits. So we have apple, mango, and orange. So we use this symbol. So this is a brace, brackets rather. So we have square brackets, and then for tuple, so we have open and close parentheses. Okay, so we have tuple of numbers, ano? So we have numbers yung nasa collection natin, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so we have dictionary or dicliterars. So sa dictionary, meron tayong key and then value. So ang key natin dito is A, and then ang value is apple. B, this is the key, and then the value is ball. C, ito yung key, and then the value is cat, separated by colon. And then we have the set. Set, ano, so we sa dictionary and set literals, we use open and close curly braces or simply braces. So dinisplay natin yung fruits, numbers, alphabets, and vowels. So this would be the output. Okay, so aside from, okay, so we already completed ano yung ating literal. So let's proceed to the next topic. So our next topic is about data types. So sabi natin kanina, no, so pag nagde-declare tayo ng variables sa other programming language, meron we explicitly define the data types. So in Python, hindi. Pero not necessarily na walang data types sa Python. So every value in Python has a specific data type. Since everything is an object in Python, or in Python programming, everything is object. So data types are actually classes and variables. So data types are actually the classes, and the variables are the instance. Ano yung variables natin? So these are the objects. Objects of this, or object of the classes. Ayan. So this is the data type. Okay. So meron tayong mga nabanggit kanina, no, na mga literals, ano. So pag numbers, so meron yung literals natin can be integer. So yun din yung magiging data type natin, ano. So we have integer, floating point, and complex. For strings, ano, so we have data type for string, and then we also have data type for boolean and other data types, ano. Okay, so we can also use the function type, no, yung type function. So ginagamit natin ito to know what kind or which class the variable or a value belongs to. Okay, so dito malalaman natin kung anong klase ng variable yung specific value. Okay, so another, aside from using type, we can also use the isInstance function. So yung isInstance function returns value true or false. Okay, so let's have this example, ano. So meron tayong variable A, nag-assign tayo ng 5. So dito naman nag-assign tayo ng 2. Ito naman nag-assign tayo ng complex. So nung ipinrint natin, print A, so anong type daw yung A? So sa palagay niyo, anong type to? Anong klase ng literal value itong 5? Anybody? Okay, very good. So this is integer. So yung pangalawang example, anong klase ng literal ito? Na-discuss natin to kanina. So this is a number with decimal. So ayan ay. Okay, so we have float, you know? So we have float, you know? So float literals. And then this one, 1 plus 2j, so this is anong klase? So this is complex, ano. So ang ginamit naman natin dito is instance, ano. So tina-check natin whether yung value na 1 plus 2j is complex or not. So although alam naman natin na ito ay talagang complex, pero meron tayong method or functions na pwedeng gamitin. So ang result is true. So ibig sabihin, yung 1 plus 2j is a complex number. This is a complex number. Okay. So nabanggit natin kanina, aside from numbers, meron din tayong list. So unang list, collection. So una sa collection na yung tinatawag na list. So list is an ordered sequence of items. So it is one of the most used data type in Python. So because this is very flexible. Kung natatandaan ninyo sa other programming language, gumagamit tayo ng open and close square brackets or simply brackets. Ginagamit natin 'yan sa array kung natatandaan ninyo, no, sa C++, sa Java. So ang brackets ay ginagamit ng array.
Kaya lang, ang characteristic ng array, so the value o yung value na ina-assign natin sa array should be same data type. So, hindi pa pwede ng merong mixed data type. So, dito sa Python, yung list niya, dahil flexible nga siya, it can hold different data types. Ano? So, pwede nga kamukha na to. So, sa list natin, so we have integer, we have float, and then we have string. So, magkakasama siya dun sa list. Okay, so declaring list is pretty straightforward. So, item separated by comma and close within square brackets. So, that's how we declare or we assign yung list dun sa ating variable. Okay, so another thing is dun sa list natin, ano, so we can use the slicing operator. The slicing operator is square brackets to extract an item or range of item from the list or the index, ano. Okay, so di ba sa atin, ano, sa array, alam ko naman, alam nyo din yung array. So meron tong index. Sige nga kung natatandaan niyo. Kung meron ta, ito yung ating list or ito yung array natin. Ano yung index ng 5? What? Okay, very good. 0. So kung ito ay 0, ito yung 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So kung meron tayong A2, so ano yung value ng A2? So this is a comment, 'di ba? So ibig sabihin lang na to, pinapakita lang niya na to, ang value ng A2 ay 15. So bakit naging 15? Nagsimula tayo ng 0, 1, 2. So ibig sabihin, so yung nag-print siya, no? So ang magiging magiging output natin dito is A2 and then 15. So ang ibig sabihin ng value ng A2 natin is 15. So yun yung pag-slice natin using the square brackets. Okay. So another example is we can have this. So meron tayong beginning and then ending. So this is the index kung saan tayo magsisimula, and then ito yung index kung saan tayo magtatapos, -1. Okay. So bakit naging 5, 10, 15 yung naging value? So kaya naging 15, 5, 10, 15. So we start with 0. So index 0, index 1, index 2. So hindi nakasama yung 3 kasi 3 minus 1. So palagi yung sa last value, nagma-minus tayo ng yung number na nakalagay dito, minus 1. Kaya ang nade-display niya yung index 0 to 0 to 2. Okay. So ang kaya magiging output ay 5, 10, and 15. So about this one. So magsisimula tayo, ang beginning natin ay 5. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's why, and then wala naman tayong in-specify na index para dun sa huli. So ibig sabihin sabihin na natin any numbers na nandun sa list. So yun yung madi-display. Kaya na-display dito ay 30, 35, and 40. Nasusundan ba yun? Okay. So let's have this example, ano. So I will launch the Jupyter notebook, yung ating ginagamit na code editor window para dun sa ating Python. So and then we will give example of okay. So ito, I open the Jupyter notebook. So I will create my new notebook. So para dun tayo magta-type ng ating sample code. Okay. So for example, I will actually dito, no, so meron tayong ano tawag natin dito, so this is list, ano. So aside from using list, we can also slice, ano, we can also slice of the value or yung ating string. So for example, name, sabihin na natin na A na lang. A is equal to, so magkaroon tayo ng string. Ako ay may lobo lumipad sa langit, di ko na nakita. Yan. So for example, so this is my string, ano. And then So let's use the slicing ano. So dito no yung slicing operator. So A, so I want to display na lang. So to display, so we can use the print statement and then A. Yan. So kung meron ako ng 6. So sa palagay ninyo ano yung magiging output? So ano yung magiging output nato? Anyone? Blank space. So, bakit blank space? Okay, so titingnan natin. 0, yung A. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, ang magiging output natin dito ay itong space na to. So, kasi binibilang din natin yung space. So, palitan natin para may character na lalabas. Gawin natin 7. So, pinalitan natin ng 7. So, therefore, ang lalabas dito ay letter M. So, dito sa unang print statement. So, another example natin ay sabihin na natin ang gusto natin na lumabas ay logo. Lobo lumipad sa langit. Ayan, di ko na nakita. So, ang gagawin natin, ano yung simula? So, ang simula niya ay 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Very good. So, we have 11, colon, and then wala na tayong ilalagay na karugtong kasi lahat naman ano. So, subukan natin siyang i-run. Ayan, so, lobo lumipad sa langit. So, pinalta natin ito, no? Ginawa natin 7, kaya M yung lumabas. Nasusundan po ba yun? Okay. So, what will be the output of this code segment? Itong print statement na to. So, we have A. Samita ko. Okay, so we have okay. So if I have this example, so what would be the output of this print statement? 4, 9. Anyone? I am. Okay, so tignan natin. Okay, so okay, I'm. Okay, so kaya siya I'm, ah. So kasi we have 4, 'di ba? Sisimula tayo sa 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So ibig sabihin, sisimula siyang i-display niya in beginning ay 4, and then yung number na nakalagay natin dito sa dulo ay nagma-minus tayo ng 1. So therefore, ang hahanapin natin ay yung hanggang sa 8, ang isasama natin dun sa print, ano? So kung ito yung 4, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, we have the output ay ma. Okay, nasundan po ba yun? Yes? Okay, so let's continue. So, aside from using the Python list, so we could have tuple. Okay, so sa paggawa ng tuple, so nabanggit natin kanina, we can use open and close parentheses. So, similar sa paglalagay ng values, so we use a comma to separate each values. Ayan. So, katulad din ng list, it can contains different data types. So, kung napansin nyo dito, this is a integer, string, complex. So, pwede. No. Okay. So, nabanggit natin kanina, aside from tuples, aside from a list, so we can also use strings, ano? So we can have multi-line strings, ginagamitan ng double quotes, ay triple quotation or triple double quotation para makapag-display ng or makapaglagay ng strings with multiple lines. So hindi na tayo gagamit ng escape sequence na backslash n, 'di ba? So gagamit lang tayo ng triple quotation. Okay. So what about Python set? So yung Python set is also gumagamit or pwede tayong maglagay ng multiple values. So set is an ordered collection of unique items. Ibig sabihin, hindi pwede ng may duplicate, kaya unique.
So set is defined by values separated by comma inside the braces. So gumagamit naman tayo pag gagawa ng set open and close curly braces. Ano, items is unset. So item is a set. So these are not ordered, ano? So hindi siya ordered list, ano? Or ako napansin niyo dito, no? Napansin niyo yung 5 2 3 1 4. Pero nung dinisplay natin, ano, i-arrange niya from lowest to highest. Okay. So dito din sa Python set, kung napansin niyo, nabanggit natin kanina na yung Python set ay meron siyang unique values dapat. Since dito sa example natin ay meron siyang duplicates. So yung 2 na ulit ng dalawang beses, yung 3 ay naulit ng tatlong beses. Pero nung dinisplay natin yung A, so nire-remove niya yung ating duplicates. So in this example, so yung indexing nga natin ay insignificant, so or it has no meaning. And also yung paggamit ng slicing tool ay hindi gagana kapag tayo ay gumagawa ng set. Okay, so another kailangan natin na maintindihan is yung paggawa ng dictionary. So dictionary is an ordered collection of key value pair. So this is key, colon, and then value. So this is key, and then this is value. Okay, so kung napansin nyo dito, no? So anong type yung D? So ang value, yung D, ang value niya ay dic, ano, or dictionary. So it is generally used when we have huge amount of data, no? So ginagamit natin ito, yung key value pair, to optimize, ano, the retrieving of data. So we must know the key to retrieve the particular value. So for example, we want to retrieve the value dito, yung value. So we need to use 1. Kung gusto natin na makuha yung value na 2, so we need to use the key. The key, ang key natin na name is key. Okay, so another example. So we have, in this example, so D1, ano yung D1? So yung 1 dito, hindi ito yung index, ano? So nakalagay kasi dito, yung key natin is 1. So therefore, the value of D1 is value. And then we have D key. Ano, D and then key, so this is the key, so the value of the key is 2, so therefore ito ang magiging output niya ay 2. So dito naman D2, so mag-generate siya ng error kasi yung 2 dito ay hindi naman siya key, siya ay value, so that's why it will generate error. Okay, so another important thing to remember is yung tinatawag na casting or yung pag-convert from or pag-convert between data types. So we can convert different data types by using different type conversion such as int, float, string. So ito, nakita natin dito, meron tayong, we want to convert integer, float literals, 10.6. Kinonvert natin into integer, so tawag natin dito is casting. Ano? So kinast natin into integer, so naging output is 10. So ito naman ay negative value, negative 10.6, meron din siyang floating points. So yung float natin na literal ay kinast into integer. Kaya nawala yung decimal places, naging negative. So this is how we use the int, float, and then str na function. So dito naman, integer siya, kinas natin into float, kaya nagkaroon siya ng decimal place. Ito naman, anong klase ng data type to? Anyone? Anong klase? Okay, very good. Kasi merong single quotation. So, this is a string. So, kinonvert yung string na maging float. Kaya, ang naging output natin is 2.5. So, ito naman, yung string, kinonvert naman natin into itong 25 ay kinoconvert natin into string, kaya nagkaroon siya ng single quotation. So sa pagko-convert ng string to numerical value, so see to it na pagka nag-convert tayo, yung meron siyang equivalent na, no, yung string ay may equivalent na number. Kasi pagka may kasamang letter at i-convert natin siya sa number, magkakaroon, syempre, mag-generate yan ng error. Okay. And then, this is the last topic that we're going to discuss. So, this is the Python input-output. Also, yung pag-i-import. Okay. So, pag sinabi natin na sa Python, so there are numerous, or it also provides numerous built-in functions that are available. Okay, so one of the functions na typical na ginagamit natin is yung pagde-display. So yung print function. So ever since na tayo ay nagsimula, so we use the print function, no? So para dun sa pagde-display ng output. And then para naman maging more dynamic, or we can ask input from the user, so we can use the input function. So these are the two functions that are widely used for standard input output operation. Okay, so let's have the print function. So nagagawa naman na natin ito, no? So in this example, we print this string. So that's why we use print, and then this is the output. This sentence is output to the screen. Okay. And then another example. Okay, so we have a is equal to 5, so we assign a as value of 5. So para tayo ay mag-concatenate, so in Java we use plus sign. So dito naman, so we can concatenate, so yung sa pagpiprint natin, so we can use comma. So we have a string here and another's so this is an integer. So ito yung magiging output niya. So mas simple, no? So para makapag-add kayo ng or makapaglagay ng additional na value dun sa string, so we use comma para dun sa print. Okay. So aside from this, actually when we use the print function, so the actual syntax of the print function is this. So we have the object. So ito yung gusto natin na i-print, no? Object siya. Yung string na piniprint natin, so ina-assign natin siya sa object. And then we have the sep. Sep is separator. Ano? And then we have end. So the default, so since ito yung default, so yung separator niya, ang default ay walang separator. End, so ibig sabihin ng backslash end, every time na gumagamit tayo ng print function, yung susunod na statement ay mapiprint next line. And then yung file and flush, so seldom naman niya na ina-alter. Okay. So in this example, so we declare print 1 2 3 4 5. Ay 1 2 3 4. So this will be the output. So ngayon, we use the sep, no? So we alter the sep instead of placing a null value, so wala siyang laman. Naglagay tayo ng asterisk. So ibig sabihin in between 1 2 3 4, we want to have a separator. The separator is asterisk. So when we use print 1, 2, 3, 4, and then sep. So, meron lang tayong comma, no, sa pagitan ng nato. And then, the output would be 1, asterisk 2, asterisk 3, 4, again. And then, ito naman, yung third example natin ay meron namang end. So, sa end, naglalagay tayo ng ampersand. So, dito naman, hashtag. So, sa pagitan ng 1, 2, 3, and 4, meron tayong hashtag. And then, sa end ay meron tayong and sign. So, this is the default default or the actual syntax of the print function. So we can alter yung separator and then yung end. Ayan. Okay? So next. Okay, so aside from using the yung paglalagay ng separator, actually we can format our output. So we use formatting, output formatting to make sure that the output is well organized, so para mas madaling basahin or it looks attractive, yung output natin. So this can be done using the str format. So this is the example. So we have x and y variable. So dito, so ito yung print natin. So this is the formatting, so para dun sa place value or dun sa paglalagyan natin ng value, so we use open and close curly braces. Ibig sabihin, dito natin ilalagay yung unang value. Dito naman natin ilalagay yung pangalawang value. Okay, so the value of x is, so this is the placeholder. And then, ny is another placeholder.
So this is our string. Kung napansin nyo, no, di ba, yung color green. And then that format x, y. So x, the value of x is 5. So yung x, yun yung mauunang placeholder. So that will be the value na mailalagay dito. No? So that's why ito yung naging output natin. The value of x is 5 and y is 10. Okay, so kakasunod naman yan. Okay, so aside from using the value from variable, we can also use open and close curly braces as placeholders. So we specify the order in which they are printed, no? So in this example, so we use a tuple index, no? So meron tayong tuple, so we have format, and then we have the corresponding value, ano? So for the first value, bread. So actually, pwede doon naman i-assign natin doon sa variable. Pero dito, diretso na inilagay yung value. No? So para doon sa unang value, bread, the second value ng tuple is butter. So para ma-identify natin, ito ay merong index. So yung index ng bread ay 0, ang butter naman ay 1. So kung meron pa kayong kasunod dito na option, or dun sa tuple, so we can use the index. Ano? So, 0. So, ang naging output natin, I love. Yung 0 ay bread. And then, yung 1 ay butter. So, dito naman pinagpalit natin. So, I love butter and bread. So, nauna yung 0. Nauna yung 1. I love butter and bread. Okay. So, second to the last topic is about Python input. So, dun sa mga previous examples natin, so we only use the print function to display a value or to display a string or value dun sa screen. So, para mas maging dynamic yung ating program, so we can allow user to input, ano, to enter value, not just yung assigned values na nanggagaling sa atin. So, to allow flexibility, so we might want to make input from the user. So, the input function allows us to ask user input. Okay. So, we have input and then prompt. So, paano yun? So, this one, so we are assigning, ano? So this is our prompt, ano? Enter a number. So, yung enter a number, ito yung lalabas natin, ito yung prompt niya. And then, kung ano yung i-input ng user, yun yung magiging value ng ating variable. So, dito, ang value ng num ay 10. Okay, so, mark Dave. So, you're raising your hand. Yes po. Yes. Yes po. Ganun lang siya. Okay, so sige, let's have this example para makita natin. Meron pa bang nagtataas ng kamay? Okay, so sagutin muna natin yung tanong ni Mr. Dison. Okay, so for example, I declare A is equal to 6.6. Sige, gawin natin yung multiple declaration. A, B, C, okay, C, D equals 1.5, 5, 5, yun natin ng string, 7, and then we have, ano pa yung kulang? Sabihin na natin na float na lang din. 6.6. Ayan. So, we want to convert. No? O, sige, display na lang muna natin yung value ng mga ito. So, using the print statement. Print A, B, C, D, E. May iba tayo hanggang D lang. Sorry. Ayan, so let's run this code. Ayan. So, kung ano yung nailagay natin dito. So, we have 1.257 and then 6.6. Ayan. So, we want to convert. Ano? So, we want to convert. So, this is yung letter A natin ay double. So, float siya. No? Float, rather. Float siya. So, we want to convert it into integer. So, we have integer. So, we're going to cast it. Ano? Yung 1.2 or hindi pala 1.2 yung A ano, so we are converting A, so i-print natin para ayan. So we want to print A, subukan natin siyang i-run. Ayan, so kung napansin nyo 1 lang yung naging output kasi ito ay float. Okay, so pagka-cast. So, i-print din natin yung kabila. So, yung pangalawang value, yung B naman, ay, siya naman ay integer. So, gawin naman natin siyang float. Okay, so, we are converting yung value ng B. Ang value ng B is 5, integer siya. We want to convert it into floating value or floating literals or float values. So, once na nilan natin yan, so, naging 5.0. So, nagkaroon siya ng point, ano yung decimal place, decimal value. Okay. So, yung letter C naman, so, ano naman yung C? Print? Ano naman yung C natin? C ay? Anong klase ng value yung 7? Yung integer ba yun? Hindi, it's not integer. So, this is, may okay, so pwede natin siya i-convert into integer or pwede din naman natin siya i-convert into float. Sige, sabihin na natin float ulit. So float float letter C. Okay, so once na ni-run natin 'yan, so magiging 7.0. So ito ay string, kinonvert natin yung string into float. So ito ay float. And then we want to convert it into string. So para may convert naman natin yan to string, so the function is str. So once na ni-run natin yan, ayan, so naging 7 ano. So yung string niya ay naging 7. So find dito ni-round off niya, no. So yung ito ngayon ay string, no. So yung 7. Itong 6.6 ay sorry. So ang hindi ko pala napalitan. So dapat dito ay magiging D. Ano? So, para ang lalabas dito ay 6.6. Ayan. So, therefore, yung 6.6 na to, ang data type niya na ay string. Okay, may question pa? Okay, so let's continue. So, wala na. Okay, so this is the last slide. So, we can also use the import statement. So, when our program grows bigger, so it is good idea to break it into a different module. So, we will be creating modules in which yung mga modules na yun ay pwede natin gamitin dun sa ating mga programs or dun sa module na ginagawa natin. So, so we can use the import statement. So, a module is file containing Python definition and statements. Python modules have file name ends with the extension .py. No? So, kapag tayo mag-i-import, yung i-import natin dapat ang extension ay py. Okay, so we have definition inside module can be imported to another module or interactive interpreter in Python. Okay, so in this example, so we have the math. Ano? So, we have math. So, math is, tawag dito, sabihin na natin na library. Ano? So, may mga ini-import tayo ng mga library. So, dito sa library na to, we can use the, sabihin na natin dito, anong gusto natin i-display yung value ng pi. So, we use the mat, and then we access the pi, mat.py. So, ang value ng pi is 3.14. So, nung pinrint natin yung mat.py, so this is the output. Ayan. Okay. So, sige. So, that is the end of our lecture. So, meron ba kayong tanong? So, kung walang tanong, sige. We're going to have your laboratory. Okay, so maraming salamat sa pakikinig at let's wait for your you wait for your laboratory.